Hello friends, welcome to my channel Local Guy. Friends, while connecting to Wi-Fi network, you have come across the authentication problem and you are unable to connect to the Wi-Fi. Even if you have entered the correct password and connected the same Wi-Fi earlier, you are still getting the authentication problem and your Android phone or tablet stuck at infinite loop of obtaining IP address or fail to obtain IP address error. So how to solve this problem permanently? Don't worry, watch this video till the end. I will show you how to solve or fix the Wi-Fi authentication problem stuck at obtaining IP address on Android phone or tablet. To fix this obtaining IP address problem permanently, first we have to find what is the reason we are getting this issue. There are mainly two issues. First, router issue. Second, issue with the Android device itself. The device is stuck at getting IP address, so it looks like a router problem. Router is unable to provide IP addresses. Most of the time, rebooting the Wi-Fi router will solve this problem. But if the issue obtaining IP address is not resolved, then it should be a router DHCP problem. Router's DHCP assigns the IP addresses to all the devices on the network. If your Wi-Fi router's DHCP is configured with small pool of IP ranges, it means suppose you have configured DHCP to provide IP addresses from 192.168.1.1 to 192.168.1.10, then only 10 devices can get the IP addresses from DHCP. If 11th device try to connect to the Wi-Fi network, then DHCP is unable to issue the IP address to the device dynamically because the IP address range quota is already exhausted. To solve the DHCP issue, one simple solution is you can assign static IP addresses manually to the Android phone or tablet. For that, go to Settings, then Wi-Fi, then tap on Connected Wi-Fi. Under Wi-Fi network details, find IP settings and change IP settings from DHCP to static and assign the IP address from the same network subnet. Here on my router's DHCP settings, my subnet is 192.168.1.0, so I can assign any IP addresses from the range 192.168.1.1 to 192.168.1.254, excluding the DHCP range. Here my DHCP range is from 192.168.1.100 to 192.168.1.111. While assigning static IP addresses, do not use DHCP defined range. Let's assign static IP address 192.168.1.112. Then gateway address is router's IP address, which is 192.168.1.1, and prefix length or subnet mask 24 bit or 255.255.255.0, and DNS is router's IP address, or you can use Google's DNS 8.8.8.8 or 8.8.4.4 and save. You can see that now we are connected to the Wi-Fi network. While assigning the static IP address, make sure that IP address you are going to assign is not obtained by any other device on the network, otherwise it will cause IP conflict with other devices. If you don't want IP conflict or static IP address and want DHCP to assign IP addresses dynamically, then you have to do some settings on Wi-Fi router. For that, access the Wi-Fi router using its IP address. Here my Wi-Fi router IP address is 192.168.1.1. Now, log into Wi-Fi router with credentials. Most of the time, its username is admin and password is also admin. Now navigate to DHCP and under DHCP settings, increase your IP pool range. Here, I am increasing from 192.168.1.1 to 192.168.1.254 and save the settings. Now, reconnect to the Wi-Fi network from the device you are facing the issue. You can see that now device has obtained the IP address dynamically from the DHCP. Friends, DHCP assigns the IP address to the device on lease basis. The router remembers the MAC address of the device with assigned IP address till the lease time expires. So next time when you reconnect with the same Wi-Fi network before the lease time expires, the router will issue the same IP address which it has assigned earlier. But if you try to reconnect after lease time expired, then router will assign the new IP address from the pool. But if you have limited DHCP IP pool range, and after lease time expired, and if you have provided the Wi-Fi password to your friends or neighbor, and if your neighbor's device connect to your Wi-Fi before you, then router will assign the IP address to neighbor's device, and when you try to reconnect the Wi-Fi network, then because of DHCP IP pool exhausted, your device will stuck at obtaining IP address. To solve this issue permanently, log into Wi-Fi router and navigate to DHCP, and under DHCP settings, find IP address reservation. Here, add the MAC address of the device and assign the IP address to that MAC address. So router will reserve that IP address for that device MAC address and will not assign that IP address to someone else's device. On public Wi-Fi, obtaining IP address problem is common because many users access the Wi-Fi, so IP address is exhausted quickly. And if lease time is 24 hours, then new users have to wait until lease time expires. So it's better to configure lease time 30 minutes on public Wi-Fi. Friends, sometimes stuck at obtaining IP address loop occurs because of Wi-Fi security settings. Change authentication type to WPA to PSK and encryption to AES. One of the reason is MAC filtering. If you have enabled the MAC filtering, then disable it. Sometimes changing the Wi-Fi channel number can also resolve the problem. Friends, if above router side settings do not solve the problem and issue persists, then the problem is with Android phone, some Android Wi-Fi software glitch. There are 7 solutions to fix authentication problem on Android phones. First solution is to forget the Wi-Fi network and reconnect with the password. Second solution is turn on airplane mode and turn off after 30 seconds. You will be able to connect to the Wi-Fi. Repeat the process 2 or 3 times if not solved. Third solution is to clear Google Play service cache. Fourth solution, on some devices, renaming the phone will resolve the problem. Fifth solution is to reboot the device. Sixth solution is to reset network settings. Seventh solution is reset the device to factory default. Friends, above solutions will definitely solve the authentication problem like stuck at obtaining IP address loop or fail to obtain IP address. So that's it for today. If you have any query about the settings, then ask me in the comments. Thanks for watching the video. Like, share and subscribe to the channel. Till then, goodbye.